take a moment just to say thank you for the mercy you gave me today. You woke me up this morning, let me see another day. The way you love me is the reason that I give you praise.
There's no one worthy of,
there's none worthy,
my praise,
no
one love but you. So I
will glorify,
Lord, I magnify,
I give all the honor to you.
Honor to you.
In the valley,
hide me
from the storm, from the rain.
My God is awesome. Heal me when I'm broken.
Just heal me when I'm broken.
Where I am,
even when I'm weak.
Forever He will reign.
Forever He'll rule, He'll reign.
Awesome, my God is awesome. You're awesome, you're us stuck on our own self. You can't forget how you look. How other folk might be looking at you. You close your eyes and go to worship and God can come in. And it ain't nothing like being in God's presence. Because in the Bible says in God's presence, there's no need, there's no want. You won't need nothing else. You won't need nobody to even encourage you. If you can just get in God's presence. And you can't get in God's presence in yourself. That's why God looking for some folk that can lose themselves. Jesus said, if any man would be my disciple, let him first deny himself. Look at somebody and say, you hung up on yourself? You love yourself that much you can't lose yourself to get where God is? Hallelujah. Come on now. You can't lose yourself where you might get it fall on your knee like this sister came up to the altar and just fell all out on the floor. No, you so proud and act like you all of that. You ain't hitting on nothing. Ain't none of us hitting on nothing without God. But if you just take a moment right now and lose yourself, take the focus off everybody else, and you just get in God's presence. Woo! Hallelujah. You can't be looking at me now. You got to look for God. You got to look at God. Forget about you. Forget about me. Focus just on God. That's how you get into the place to worship. You get to the point, nothing else matter. Nothing else matter. All I want to do is to stay right here. I sense God's presence. I know God is with me. I feel his anointing. You don't want to leave God's presence when you get in his presence. You don't worry about the benediction when you get in God's presence. You don't worry about me being long-winded when you get in God's presence, y'all. Thank you, Jesus. Woo! Hallelujah. The Bible says in that same passage there, the 4th chapter of St. John, and God said, the time will come. You say that in Jerusalem is where you should worship. That means at the church. And the Samaritans say, no, you don't got to go to church. You can worship in the mountain. So that's where the woman was, in the mountain. Jesus said, wait a minute, you got this thing mixed up. Let me prophesy to you, he said. He said, the time is coming in 9 years when anybody that worship, you don't have to go to Jerusalem to worship. Y'all hear me? And you don't even have to come to this mountain to worship. But just get in the spirit wherever you at. That's where you worship when you get in God's presence. You at the church, but you ain't necessarily at God in God's presence. Because if you get in his presence, the devil can't bother you. He can't whisper in your mind. He can't have you sitting there judging, saying things. But when you get in God's presence, there ain't nothing but the fullness of the Holy Ghost in God's presence. You ain't worried what nobody said to you, not how nobody did you. You just glad to be in God's presence. Hallelujah. You lift both your hands and throw back your head. And give God the thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord. You can only sing in his presence. Lose yourself. Lose yourself. And say glory, Glory, glory to your name. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory.
Keep it real. I used to be one of those saints, you know, self-righteous and didn't know it. I didn't know it. I just thought if you were totally, completely saved, there would be no temptation coming your way. Well, what part of the Bible did I forget when Jesus was tempted in all areas that we are? Well, we better keep it real and keep it straight. And up in here on today, The Community Temple Church gave me the topic of the wisdom of women. Women, we have to be wise. And I'd like to also say right there, men need to be wise too. But since this is women's, Proverbs 31:26 says, she opens her mouth with wisdom, and on her tongue is the law of kindness. The Bible says, by loving kindness have I drawn them. I used to fuss when I get up here. Fuss. I thought that's what you had to do. If you don't live holy, you're dying and going to hell. Now, that's true, but I wasn't supposed to come beating you up. I was supposed to come in the spirit of love. Back in the day, we had some church mothers. Woo, Jesus. Oh, woo. All I got to say is, woo, Jesus. But you know what? When we know better, we do better. We thought that's how we had to operate. But now we have so much to deal with in this earth. I don't come to church to get beat up. When you tell me the truth, tell it to me in the spirit of love and the spirit of kindness. And I want you to, I'm giving you my subject, and I want you to say this with me. With God, I can get through this. Boy, that song was just right on time. I like it when you're coordinating. With God, we can get through this. I'd like to put emphasis on the word can. Now, can means it indicates physical or mental ability to do something. For example, I can carry my Bible. I can. There are people with muscular problems that cannot, but I can carry my Bible. Even though I use my phone now and I can get it faster, click.com and you know it's right there. But I can carry my Bible. Back in the day when President Obama was the president, I'd rather say his name than the other name. So I'll talk about President Barack Obama. He could veto, and he said, yes, I can veto congressional bills if I choose to. Well, there was a song back in the day. It was titled, Yes, I Can, Yes, I Can, Yes, I Can. Now, I know none of you heard that. First of all, you're probably not old enough, but now, Elvie, do you remember that song, Elvie? Come on now. Let's go. And it was, Yes, I Can, Yes, I Can, Yes, I Can. And you know, back in the day, we called all those songs devil songs, but you know, some of the devil songs were not devil songs. They just weren't written by preachers or gospel people. But some of the words were inspired, I believe, by the Holy Ghost. Some of the young women date men that don't have a job. There was a song I used to skate to on Monday night called Get a Job. Sha-na-na-na. Sha-na-na-na-na. Oh, that was right in line with the Bible that said, if a man doesn't work, he does not eat. So that's scripturally sound to me. Get a job. And then some of the men go out with young sanctified women and want to treat them any kind of way. Then I believe the Lord inspired evangelist Aretha Franklin. You better give me a little R-E-S. Can you spell it? R-E-S-P-E-C. I'm not the only one in here that don't talk, act like you don't know. Acting like you don't. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Some of that is true. See, it's first natural, then spiritual. We live in this world. There are a lot of songs that have good meaning. If you can't pay your way, every time we go out to eat, you forgot your wallet, mister. Oh, really? The first time, it might be true. Second time, third time, devil is a lie. And Deacon Ray Charles said, hit the road, Jack. And don't you come back when? No more. No more. No more. Good advice. Happy to see First Lady Sheila Jordan coming in here. Who is that sitting beside you? Pastor Jake. God, stand up, Pastor. Glad to have you. Stand up, Pastor Jake, darling. I'm your auntie. Stand up. Thank you. I pull rank. Thank you for being here. God bless you. Well, some ladies don't want them to hit the road no matter how badly they've been treated. Don't ever be that desperate that you'll let him treat you any kind of way, and then tell him you're not a member of the Secret Service. You have not been hired by the president to be on the Secret Service Committee. You ain't hiding me. Don't ever want to bring me in public. Check out why. Usually they got a wife that they told you they didn't have somewhere. Why else would you have to be a secret? And then if he thinks I'm too ugly to come out, don't be with him anyway. Yeah. Think more of yourself, women. Yeah. And I know it's hard to let go of something you really want. But say with me, with God, I can get through this. Hallelujah. I'm glad you gave me permission to talk. You did say I could talk, right? Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Kurt Carr has a song that says, I know God can because I've seen him do it. Ty Tribbett says, if he did it before, he can do it again. So whatever is thrown your way, it can happen. Well, you told me, did you tell me I could talk in here today? Well, years and years and years ago, I had excruciating pain with cancer. And I'm not going through that because most of you have heard it. It was fourth stage. Pain that was indescribable. Pain so bad to go to the bathroom, I had to crawl. But I made up my mind because too many of my relatives, my mama, my daddy, my uncle died of cancer. I said, no. The buck will stop here. The doctor told me, you know, it's bad. I was at the Cleveland Clinic. But you know what? You got to get some faith. I'm talking about that unwavering. And the worse, the more I would praise God, the worse my pain would get. So I told the punk devil, read this. I put my scripture, because the cancer was in my left ovary, and I said, read this while you're down there messing. Read the word of God. So long story short, went to the Cleveland Clinic, and I kept going back. Was in there for surgery, got in there. Hey, tell your neighbor, hey. Precious memories. That's how I know how to write that because of Prince Jordan. Ooh, wait a minute. Rap, Jake. Your uncle. Hello. Woo. Okay, back to my message. You're at the stoplight and don't know which way to go because that's who's on your mind. He said, but hey, God, darling, I'd rather have Jesus. I love God more, and I got to let this go. It's hard. And let me tell you something. They had a thing, don't do drugs, just stop. Some things aren't that easy to just stop. Oh, I thought it was just that easy to just stop. But sometimes it's a process. You got to pray, fast, make up your mind. I want to do what's right and pleasing to my God and let it go. Oh, no, so surely not condoning sin. I'm just letting you know that I understand the temptations of life that I didn't understand before. Oh, you keep on living, honey. You will, you will grow up and understand some stuff. Yeah, so surely been tempted. I know you want to know how, but I ain't telling you. But let me tell you. I ask you, could we talk? And can we keep it real? Hello, y'all. I had to just say no. Ooh. I didn't say what it was, John. But you keep living, you learn. You can't understand how folk could do what they do when they grew up in the church. Oh, but I understand that. Sometimes that tempter can be so tempted and dangling that right in front of your face. But you have to make a decision. Choose God and do the right thing. But I can say I chose God and done the right thing. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. But I can't tell you it wasn't dangling before me, Nina. I've had to learn. But see, now I can talk like this. I couldn't talk like this before. But we still got to live holy and do the right thing. Even though I understand, I do understand that the wages of sin is death. Ah, but the gift of God is eternal life, and the mind of man cannot imagine what the Lord has in store. Oh, my God. Abraham, it's hard to give up something you're bonded to. Oh, but if it doesn't please God, let it go. My chocolate cake may not be your chocolate cake. My chocolate cake might be whatever my chocolate cake is. Others might be alcohol. Others might be drugs. Others might be stealing. Some folk lie. Some folk go to the mall and just take a dress and wear it on Sunday and take it back and return it, tuck the tags in. And when you get your new dress home and you smell something, oh yeah, one of the Satans shouted in it. That's stealing. That's stealing. Really? I'm stealing. Know of a person that every month they had new decorations in their home because they had 30 days to return them. Oh, you go up in there, the house, oh, this is so beautiful. You got something new. Well, it's 29 days. And you won't see it tomorrow. That's not fair. That's not being honest. There's a lot of when you looking down on somebody else and you doing your little stuff too. Don't do it. That's what I'm here to encourage you. Don't do it. Just cause somebody's strung out on drugs and they're just in the crack house, you pray for them. No matter what it is, pray.
finding God can bring joy when you don't feel like you got none. Finding God will bring peace in your mind when you're living in the midst of confusion. Finding God will put money in your pocket when you ain't got none. Cause God still lets you get what you need without money. I heard.